The goal for today is to fix a drippy faucet. It's the hot water side. It's not bad, but it does leak a little bit. It's kind of came to the point where we're actually shutting the water off below the sink. So that's pretty inconvenient. So we know the problem is here because when we shut the water off that comes to the valve, it doesn't leak anymore. So we know it's this one. This is the hot water side, this is the cold water side. And the leak is ever so slight. I mean, a lot of people might just live with it, but I think this might be repairable without even replacing the O-rings that are inside this valve. I think I'm gonna just try some plumber's grease, put it back together and see if that holds it. If not, then we'll have to go buy a little gasket kit and replace some parts. But you see the water just keeps coming, you know, I dry my hand off and then, you know, there's still water there. So it just takes a little while for the bubble to drip, but it's still there. So the first thing I'm gonna do is under the sink and turn the valve off so that that water goes away. And there you go, the valve underneath the sink is off. So now I can safely take this apart without water spraying all over the place. The first tool you'll need is a Allen wrench. This one's 3/32 for this particular one. Different valve bodies are gonna have different attaching hardware, but this one is a Allen wrench. I have this little, in my to-go kit, I have this little Harbor Freight, you know, multiple Allen wrench kit. A single one would be a little bit easier to work with. Let's see if that's loose. Oh, there we go. And off it comes. Next step will be to remove this large nut and then the whole thing should come out. Normally I would just use an adjustable wrench, also referred to as a crescent wrench, but that's a brand, not an actual tool. Adjustable wrench, but I don't have one in my to-go toolbox that is large enough, so plumber's best friend, adjustable pliers. Is that a little loosened? That's good to see that I didn't over tighten it when I put it together in the first place. And yeah, there we go. So here's the little washer rubber gasket down in there. I'm gonna have to get a pair of pliers to pull it out. I suspect that's the culprit, and so what that does is it seals right against that surface and it's just not cutting it anymore. It could be wore out, but because it popped out so easily, it may be. But I think I'm gonna just use, like I said, the plumber's grease on it, put it all back together. Now, this one's a little different than any I've ever seen, but I may have to replace this whole cartridge. Here's another rubber gasket here, an O-ring. So I gotta make sure that one's properly placed because I don't think it was. I think it goes up here. Like so. So I'll put a little grease on that as well. Put it all back together. So this here is the grease I'll be using. And then you find this in the plumbing department in pretty much any big box store or something just like it. This is whatever this brand is. So had it for years. It lasts like forever. And that's what it looks like. Kind of a white silicone grease. Pretty important that I put it together correctly. I'm just dabbing some of the grease on this side, and I'll put some on the inside. This is the side. It's kind of a, I got a thin lip to it, and that thin lip sits down in a groove down inside the valve body. So we'll just put a little grease around it. And I think I'm going to stick it. I think I'm going to just stick it. The grease should hold it. Well, maybe not. That's probably too wet. I was thinking about just sticking it to that. And actually, I'm going to put a little grease right there too. Actually, it's a little dirty because we have hard water. Calcium is built up on that. So I actually might just need to clean that off. The calcium might be what's causing it to leak. Oh yeah, it's got a definite edge to it. Let's see if I can get an angle. You can kind of see where it's got a circle there. That's actually a calcium deposit. And rub marks. I think I got it off. Oh, there's still a little bit there. Might have to take a little, I don't want to scratch it because put scratches in it and the water can find those grooves in the scratches. Just trying to use my fingernail. Just there's a little edge right there. Okay. There's actually a little scratch in it. Very hard to see, but right there is a little scratch. That could be what it is that's causing the leak. Doesn't take much. Water can find its way through the smallest space. So, I think I got enough grease on this part. I am going to give it plenty. And I'm going to take my pliers. I was going to try to put it down with the valve body, but it didn't want to stick to the surface. Uh-oh. Does want to stick to my finger, though. All right, that's good. And then again, I think I'm going to go ahead and take a dab of this grease. Oh, boogers. Put it around the O-ring. It's going around here. And basically, how this valve works, I see, is the water, when you turn the valve, it lines it up with the water spigot inside the valve body, and then it goes in through there. It's a little hard to see in this black, but then it comes out through here. And when it comes out through here, then it comes into the mixer and into this. Pretty simple. Kind of neat. It's kind of fun taking stuff apart and seeing how it works. So, see if I put this back together correctly. There we go. That's good. And then this piece, which I'm not sure has something to do with how the handle, I believe, catches. That went right there. I don't think I even had to do that right now. And then, again, when you're putting these together, you do not want to over-tighten them because you'll smash the rubber gaskets, and then water can get by it again. So I'm hardly putting any pressure on it. And I have a tendency to Gorilla grip everything, so I barely put any pressure on it. Now watch, I'll get this one done, it'll stop leaking, and next week this one will fail. But at least we have a plan for putting it together. All right, so that's that. Put the handle back on. It was pointing this way when I took it off. And actually, for testing, I don't even have to tighten it right now. I could just leave it loose in case I have to take it back apart. This faucet set's probably close to 12 years old. There. That's on there. Snug enough. Go ahead and put it in the off position. Turn the water on down below. And if I did it completely wrong, it'll just come spraying out. Yay. Let's see. Little air pockets. I'm working on it. Watch it for a minute or two. I can already tell it's working though. And those rubber pieces don't cost very much. A couple bucks at Home Depot or Lowe's. And, you know, if you have to go to a local plumbing supply store. This faucet's so old, it might be difficult to find the right ones. But hopefully they used a very generic, you know, type gasket kit. And you're able to find the replacement parts. But, yeah. No water. Working great. So that's your tip for today.